So today we'll be discussing about regenerated cellulosic fiber. So viscose rayon comes under this category. Okay. Rayon is the oldest fiber and it is also called as regenerated cellulosic fibers. Rayon is the general term applied to the man-made fibers which have a cellulosic base. During its development, it has been designated by various names such as artificial silk, wood silk, fiber silk, and art silk. The implication in these names is that it was originally intended to be a substitute for silk fiber. It is a general term for manufactured fibers or yarns produced chemically from cellulose or with a cellulose base. And for threads, strands, or fabrics made thereof, regardless of the process used in the manufacturing of such fibers, yarn, or goods. Sources of cellulose. Cellulose occur in many particles. The substances used for cellulosic material may be wood, seed hair, bast, leaf, grass, bamboo, etc. So these are all the sources of cellulose. Wood is the most common, widely used of all the cellulosic material. It is found in all over the world. The composition of wood is cellulose 40 to 50%, lignin 20 to 30%, hemicellulose 10 to 30%. So these are all the chemical composition of your wood. Cellulose is one of the most usable natural polymer worldwide. It is a biodegradable one and it is a renewable polymer. Okay, please make a note of it. It is a biodegradable and a renewable polymer. The common source for industrial purpose are wood, wood pulp, and cotton lint. See, nowadays, wood pulp is used for the manufacturing of viscose rayon, whereas cotton lint is used for the manufacturing of acetate rayon. Okay. So highly purified wood pulp consists of 95 to 99% cellulose. How much cellulose? The purified wood pulp consists of 95 to 99% of cellulose composition. It is called chemical cellulose, or you can call it as dissolving pulp. Those chemical cellulose or dissolving pulps are used for the manufacturing of man-made fibers that is called viscose rayon or acetate rayon. Okay. So the process used to make viscose can either be a continuous or batch-wise process. So the batch-wise process is used for producing a wide variety of rayons. See, there are wide variety of rayons are available, like your viscose rayon, cupromonium rayon, acetate rayon, polynosic rayon, high wet modulus rayon. There are so many varieties of rayon you can produce out of using this batch-wise process. Rayon is a versatile fiber. Why I am saying it is a versatile fiber? Because it's being chemically and structurally engineered by making use of the properties of cellulose from which it is made. So you are taking the raw material from the nature, but you are using chemicals by means of modifying some structure. Then finally you are able to produce this viscose rayon. However, it is to somewhat difficult to control uniformity between batches, and it also requires high labor involvement. See, I told you can produce the viscose rayon or a variety of rayon in a batch-wise process. The drawback in batch-wise process is the control, it is difficult to control the uniformity between batches. So there may be a quality variation between batch to batch. So that is the one difficult you may be face while choosing batch wise process. But the continuous process is the main method for producing viscose rayon. So three methods of production lead to distinctly different types of rayon fibers, that is viscose rayon, cupramonium rayon, and saponified cellulose rayon, acetate rayon. Okay. In order to produce this acetate rayon, you are using cotton lint. Whereas if you want to produce viscose rayon, you have to use cellulose from wood pulp. Similarly for cupramonium rayon also. Okay. So the raw material you are taking for the production of rayon is also varying. We want to produce viscose rayon, you have to take wood pulp. Similarly for cupramonium rayon. If you want to produce cellulose acetate rayon, you have to take cotton lint for the production of acetate rayon. So now let us discuss the different types of rayons. Rayon fibers are engineered to possess a range of properties to meet the demands for a wide variety of end use. Why we are producing wide variety of rayons? Because the end use will vary. Okay, so if the end use will vary, then you can engineer the fibers. Engineering means you can modify the fibers either by means of chemical. Okay, so basically a high wet modulus rayon. So these fibers have exceptionally high wet modulus. If you take normal viscose rayon, the normal viscose rayon is having poor wet modulus property. Poor wet modulus in the sense, if you dip the viscose rayon in water, it loses its strength drastically. So in order to overcome those problem, so a high wet modulus viscose rayon is now coming into the picture. So you can produce high wet modulus viscose rayon by chemical modification, or you can change the process modification during the production of the viscose rayon. So if you look at the high wet modulus value of this fiber is 1 g/dN. So the modulus is expressed in terms of grams per dN. So if you analyze the high wet modulus viscose rayon strength, it is 1 g/dN. So it is used in the manufacturing of parachute cots and other industrial uses. Where it is used? It is used in the manufacturing of parachute cots and other industrial uses. Now coming to the next rayon, that is polynosic rayon. These fibers have very high degree of orientation achieved as a result of very high stretch. So you can keep 300% stretch during this process. How you are getting a high degree of orientation? By means of maintaining a very high stretch up to 300% during the process. So once if you maintain very high draw ratio or the stretch ratio, you can achieve this very high degree of orientation. So whenever the degree of orientation is increasing, what will happen? Your tensile strength is very, very high. I told you in the beginning, at the starting of the first unit, isn't it? So these fibers having very high degree of orientation. Whenever the orientation increases, automatically it reflects in tensile strength property of your yarn or fabric, okay, or fiber. So how to attain this high degree of orientation? You have to maintain high stretch ratio, or you can call it as high draw ratio during the manufacturing process. These fibers have unique fibril structure and high dry and wet strength. So this fiber is having good dry as well as wet strength. Then low elongation property. See, whenever the orientation is higher, automatically elongation is also very, very low, because these two properties are having correlation. So more orientation, ultimately you will get high strength, but on the other side you will get low elongation. The fiber may not elongate. So 8 to 11% elongation only. Then relatively low water retention property and very high wet modulus. Okay, so these are all the properties you can obtain by means of maintaining high degree of orientation during the manufacturing process. So ultimately what the rayon is called? The rayon is called polynosic rayon. See, please look at the figure. This is the process flow in the manufacturing of viscose rayon. Please look at this slide. This is the process flow in the manufacturing of viscose rayon. See, first you are taking the spruce tree. So from the spruce tree, you are cutting the wooden logs. Then the wooden logs are shredded. That is, you are making into a powder form, then cooked using caustic soda solution. Then you are making into a wood pulp, that is sheets of wood pulp. Then again, the sheets of wood pulp is shredded. Shredded means you are cutting into a very small pieces, or you are making into a powder form, then treating with carbon disulfide. Then it is mixed with again caustic soda solution. Then finally the solution becomes a viscous solution. The viscous solution is passed through a coagulation bath. This coagulation bath contains spinneret. Okay. So once the filament is coming out, when it contacts with the coagulation bath, it starts precipitating. Then you can collect the filament and you can wound it onto a bobbin. So this is the process flow. So where you are taking the wood pulp, you are taking the wood pulp from the spruce tree. So next we'll discuss the step-by-step production of viscose rayon. The first step is steeping. Cellulose pulp boat contains cellulose, that is 89% of cellulose. This cellulose pulp is treated in a steeping tank. It contains 18% concentration of sodium hydroxide solution. So you have to maintain 18 degrees Celsius during this process. The duration is 60 minutes. So after treating with sodium hydroxide solution at 18 degrees Celsius for about 60 minutes, the cellulose is treated with alkali cellulose. What will happen? Your cellulose is converted into soda cellulose and it removes hemicellulose. It removes the hemicellulose present in the wood pulp. Okay. Then coming to the next process is pressing operation. The swollen alkali cellulose mass is pressed to a wet weight equivalent to 2.5 to 3 times the original pulp weight. So you have to press in order to remove the excess amount of alkali present in the cellulose pulp sheet. Okay, only you have to maintain 2.5 to 3 times the original weight of the wood pulp. Then coming to the shredding process. The alkali cellulose boards are shredded into crumbs where the rotating serrated blades are there. Here you are converting the cellulose boards into a powder form of cellulose, alkali cellulose. Okay. So this operation is carried out for about 1 to 3 hours at 25 to 35 degrees Celsius. How much degree Celsius you have to maintain? 25 to 35 degrees Celsius to be maintained during this process. Ultimately, you are getting a powder form of alkali cellulose at the end of the shredding process. So please look at the slide. This is the flow chart of viscose rayon. You are taking wood pulp, then you are steeping with sodium hydroxide solution, then pressing in the sense you are removing the excess alkali present in the cellulose pulp, then shredding process. Shredding is you are converting into a powder form, then aging. Okay, then ripening process. After ripening, dissolving with again caustic soda solution. Finally, you are getting a xanthate solution. This xanthate you are treating with again carbon disulfide. Finally, you are getting a viscous solution at the end of the treatment. So the viscous solution is filtered out, then extrusion through the spinneret. After the extrusion through the spinneret, finally you are getting a filament. The filament is then your stretching process is carried out in order to orientation of the fiber. Then you have to cut the fiber. The cutting is again depends upon the end use. If you want to mix it with cotton fiber or polyester fiber, the cutting process can be carried out. Otherwise, you can directly wind the filament onto a bobbin. Okay. This is the sequence or the flow process chart involved in the production of viscose rayon. Please look at this slide. The first one is steeping process. So in steeping, what you are doing, you are treating with alkali. So the wood pulp contains either 89 to 95% of cellulose. Okay, the sodium hydroxide concentration is 7 to 19% of sodium hydroxide concentration. Then shredding process. Then aging process. That is, you are reducing the degree of polymerization. Okay, so at the initial, the degree of polymerization may be 5000. But during the aging process, the degree of polymerization has been decreased to up to 300. Then finally, you are getting a xanthation. It is like a viscous solution. This solution is again blending, ripening, filtration, then finally spinning. Spinning in terms of coagulation bath. Coagulation bath contains sulfuric acid, zinc sulfate, then sodium sulfate. So many other chemicals are there. I'll be discussing in the forthcoming slides the functions of chemicals in the coagulation bath. Okay. So after the filament is coming out from the spinneret, then you are neutralizing, purifying, then finishing. Finishing again, it depends upon the end use of your material. Then drying, then you can wind it onto a bobbin. So the next process is aging. So this is an oxidative depolymerization step. So you have to reduce the degree of polymerization. Okay. So the crumbs are then transferred to a steel container in which they are stored under controlled temperature condition between 21 to 23 degrees Celsius. The duration here is you have to maintain 72 hours. It depends upon the catalyst and alkali. See how much time you have to keep it in the aging process. Minimum 72 hours in order to decrease the degree of polymerization. Okay. So the presence of air in the presence of alkali reduce the chain length of cellulose, that is depolymerization, resulting a decrease in viscosity. So this is really a desirable one to make a desired spinning solution. When the right viscosity is obtained, these pieces are all transferred to the drum in an inert atmosphere and kept at low temperature. So aging is very, very important. Okay, then coming to the next process is gentation. So the aged alkali cellulose is transferred to a heterometrically sealed churns. Here you are adding carbon disulfide, 32 to 35% by weight of the material. Okay, so the churn is rotated at 4 RPM. Please think it over. The churn is rotated at 4 RPM only. For about 1 to 3 hours, you have to maintain 30 degrees Celsius. So these are all the process conditions to be maintained during this gentation process. The rotation should be kept at 4 RPM. You have to maintain 30 degrees Celsius. The duration is 1 to 3 hours. So what will happen? The side reactions takes place along with the conversion of alkali cellulose to cellulose gentate. So at the beginning of the steeping process, we are treating with sodium hydroxide. So what will happen? The cellulose is converted into soda cellulose, that is alkali cellulose. Now, while treating with carbon disulfide, what is happening? The alkali cellulose is converted into cellulose gentate. Now, if you look at the color of the gentate is orange in color. So the color of the solution is becomes orange in color. So finally, you will getting resulting a viscous solution. So that is why the name called as viscous rayon. Now the orange cellulose gentate crumbs is dissolved in again using sodium hydroxide solution at 15 to 20 degrees Celsius under high shear mixing condition in order to obtain a viscous orange colored solution called viscose. Okay, so what is the purpose? The purpose is in order to mix with all the different chambers in order to obtain a viscous orange colored solution called viscose, which is the base for the manufacturing of viscous rayon. Now the viscous solution is then filtered and it is then deaerated. We have to remove the air present inside the viscous solution. Please look at the figure. See, I told you the sheets, the wood pulp, you are treating with caustic soda solution. The shredder, you are converting into a powder form. I told you, no, the churning chamber. So you have to keep 4 RPM, 30 degrees Celsius, 1 to 3 hours duration. So the churning chamber is looks like. Then the viscous solution, it becomes orange in color here. It is then filtered out. Then it is passed through the coagulation bath. So please look at the figure slide. So this is the chemical reactions takes place during the manufacturing of viscose fiber. These are all the various chemical reactions. The first one is cellulose. You are taking wood pulp. When you are treating with sodium hydroxide solution, what will happen? It becomes soda cellulose, or you can call it as alkali cellulose. Again, alkali cellulose is again you are treating with carbon disulfide. What will happen? You are getting gentate. So the color of the gentate is orange in color. So please make a note of it. Okay, so the color of the gentate is orange in color. So this is the chemical reactions takes place during the production of viscose rayon fiber. Then coming to the next step, dissolution process. So dissolution of cellulose xanthate takes place in cylindrical vessel equipped with agitators. So you have to treat it with 4 to 6% of sodium hydroxide in order to dissolve the cellulose xanthate. After the dissolution process, then filtration process. The viscous solution is filtered through a filter cloth. So the filter, what is the purpose of filtering? To remove the impurities and undissolved cellulose particles. Okay, otherwise it will block the spinnerate hole while spinning the viscose rayon fiber. So the purpose of the filtration is to remove the impurities and undissolved cellulose. Why we have to remove the impurities? Otherwise it will block the spinnerate hole during the manufacturing of the viscose rayon. Then coming to the blending. See, viscous solution from several dissolving tanks. So you have prepared so many tanks. So all the tanks has to be mixed or blended in order to obtain a homogeneous solution. Okay, so viscous solution from several dissolving tanks are blended in a large vessel to obtain a homogeneous solution. So which will remove the batch to batch variation. Okay, which will remove the batch to batch variation. So next process is ripening process. After blending, the viscous solution is transferred to a large tank in a constant temperature room where it is kept for 1 to 3 days at a temperature of 15 to 25 degrees Celsius. So after blending, there is a process called ripening process. So you have to keep the solution for about 2 to 3 days at 15 to 25 degrees Celsius. So this process is called as ripening process. Then spinning process. After ripening, the solution is passed through the spinning bath. Spinning bath contains coagulation bath. I told you coagulation. Coagulation bath contains few chemicals like sulfuric acid, sodium sulfate, zinc sulfate. I'll tell you the functions of chemicals in the coagulation bath. Okay. Then spinning of viscose into a fiber. Upon entering the bath, the viscose filament is coagulated and acid diffuses into the filament. Once the viscous solution comes in contact with the coagulation bath, it starts precipitating. Then you can take the filament and you can wind it. I told you there is a stretching. Stretching you have to maintain 300% in order to get high orientation. That is called high wet modulus viscose rayon. Here you have to maintain more stretch ratio, or you can call it as a draw ratio. Okay. So this is the schematic representation of your coagulation bath as well as your spinnerate. The filament is coming out from the spinnerate minute holes. So the coagulation bath, what it contains? It contains sulfuric acid. What is the function of sulfuric acid? The sulfuric acid to acidify the cellulose xanthate. The viscose solution extruded through the spinnerate, it comes in contact with the spin bath chemicals. It passes from a particular time in the spin bath. Sodium sulfate precipitates the sodium cellulose xanthate from the viscous into the form of filament. So what is the purpose of sodium sulfate? Sodium sulfate precipitates sodium cellulose xanthate from the viscous into the form of filament. Your sulfuric acid converts the xanthate into cellulose. What is the function of sulfuric acid? Sulfuric acid converts the xanthate into cellulose because of the reaction with spin bath chemicals in the solution. Coagulates in the form of threads of sodium cellulose xanthate. Further, it reacts with the acid to form cellulose. This reaction is a slow process which takes few hours for completion. Then what is the function of zinc sulfate? The zinc sulfate to cross-link the cellulose molecule. So these are all the functions of chemicals present in the coagulation bath. Okay. So please look at the figure. So this figure elaborates the entire viscose rayon manufacturing process. See here the wood pulp, steeping process, treating with a sodium hydroxide solution. Then it is comes under the shredder. Okay. Then you are treating with alkali. Then you are treating with the carbon disulfide. It becomes cellulose xanthate. Then you are homogeneously mixing. Then the viscous solution is passed through the ripening tank. Then the filtration process. After the filtration process, it is goes to the feeding tank. The solution is comes in contact with the coagulation bath. Once it comes in contact with the coagulation bath, it starts precipitating because of the presence of sodium sulfate. Then the sulfuric acid converts the xanthate into cellulose. Then this filament comes out. Then you can wash it, then desulfurizing, then bleaching, then conditioning, then drying, then you can wind it. Finally, you are getting a viscose rayon. So these are all the 10 steps are involved in the production of viscose rayon. Okay. So next one is drying process. So after the filament making process, whether you can call it as it is a drying process or stretching process or the draw ratio. Okay. So the rayon filaments are stretched. So what is the purpose of stretching? In order to improve the orientation present in your filament. So this causes the chains to stretch out and orient along the fiber axis. So chain becomes more or less parallel. Interchain hydrogen bond formation also takes place. So filaments with necessary properties for use it as textile fiber. So after the drying process or stretching process, then the filaments comes into the washing process. So here it contains so many impurities like salts and other water soluble impurities. So these impurities have to be removed. So several washing techniques can be adopted to remove the impurities present in your viscose filament. Then cutting. Cutting, it depends upon the again end use. Suppose if the viscose rayon is to be blended with our cotton fiber, you can cut it into a staple form. You can cut it into a staple form of fiber by means of cutter. I don't want to become a staple fiber, then you can directly wound it onto a bobbin. Okay. So again, please look at this slide. So this shows the entire viscose rayon production process. This is the schematic representation of your viscose rayon manufacturing process. Okay. Sodium hydroxide, alkali cellulose, zinc, xanthate, viscose solution, coagulation bath contains sulfuric acid. Then drawing process, first drawing, second drawing. Then if you want to do the staple fiber, so you can cut the continuous filament fiber into a staple fiber by means of cutter. Then you can collect those staple fibers, then mix it with either cotton or polyester. Okay, Otherwise, you can directly wound it onto a bobbin, then drying. Okay. So again, this is also one more schematic representation of your viscose rayon production. So this is the flow chart. First purification of cellulose, then conditioning of wood pulp, steeping, shredding, aging, churning, dissolving, ripening, then spinning.
More Research has the resources to optimize the process going from wood to dissolving cellulose and all the way to viscose fibers. To be able to do this, we need to evaluate how various parameters in different process steps affect the processability and the final product quality. This is possible by using More Research pilot equipment, which covers the whole value chain, the entire process from a log through barking, chipping, sorting, cooking, bleaching, production of viscose dope, and finally spinning of viscose fibers can be simulated. But it is also possible to focus on selected parts of the value chain. The viscose process can be simulated in small scale by using our Triber microviscose pilot plant together with our spinning pilot equipment. The first step in the viscose process is a steeping of the dissolving cellulose in sodium hydroxide. The cellulose is swelling and thereby become more reactive towards the chemicals used later in the process. The hemicellulose in the pulp is removed by dissolving it in the steeping lye. The excess sodium hydroxide is removed from the pulp by using mechanical pressing and vacuum. The pulp is shredded to make the cellulose more accessible to the chemicals. One of the most important steps is the pre-aging, where the cellulose chains are cut into shorter pieces through a reaction with oxygen from the air. This reaction will continue until a certain length of the cellulose chains are obtained. In the sanctation, carbon disulfide is added to the cellulose, forming cellulose sanctate. The yellow color of the cellulose are caused by bioreactions from the carbon disulfide. The cellulose sanctate is diluted in a sodium hydroxide solution. The ripening of the viscose dope continues overnight up to 16 hours. The cellulose and alkali content is analyzed both in the alkali cellulose after pre-aging and in the final viscose dope. Other properties that are analyzed on the viscostope is filterability, gamma number, particle size distribution, and bowfall. The finished viscostope are filtered to remove solid particles that otherwise would clog the spinnerets. The viscostope are pressed through a spinneret containing small holes and out into the spin bath. When the viscose comes in contact with the spin bath, the cellulose is regenerated and a viscose filament is formed out of each hole in the spinneret. The filaments are stretched between two wheels.
Now let us discuss the chemical structure of viscose rayon. Chemical structure of viscose rayon is similar to that of cotton. Cellulose, but the polymer chains are much shorter than your cotton fiber. If you look at the degree of polymerization of viscose rayon is 400 to 700, whereas your cotton is 5000. Please look at the figure. This is the chemical structure of your viscose rayon. Now let us discuss the physical properties of viscose rayon. Tenacity 2.4 to 3.2 grams per denier. If you look at the density of the viscose rayon is 1.64 to 1.54. Elongation at break is 13%. Elasticity, it has good elasticity property. The moisture regain of viscose rayon is 11 to 13%. Your melting point, yes, this fiber does not melt. If you heat the viscose rayon at about 150 degrees Celsius, the fiber becomes weak. The color of the viscose rayon is white in color. Please look at the table, the moisture content 13% at 27 degrees Celsius at 65% RH relative humidity. Your tensile strength at dry state 1.5 to 2.4 grams per denier, whereas in wet state 0.7 to 1.2 grams per denier. So this is the drawback of your normal viscous rayon. It has poor wet strength. Elasticity 2% to 3% elasticity in nature. The specific gravity is 1.53. Effect of heat. If you heat the polymer at 149 degrees Celsius, the rayon starts to lose its strength, whereas at 177 degrees to 204 degrees Celsius, rayon starts to convert into char and get decomposed. So this is the property of your viscous rayon with respect to the heat. Effect of sunlight. It gets weakened due to moisture and ultraviolet rays. Elongation at break 15 to 30% elongation. Now let us discuss the chemical properties of viscous rayon. The first one is degradation. Cellulose is extremely sensitive to the action of acid and also to oxidation. Acid produces hydrocellulose. When you treat the viscous rayon in a strong acid, what will happen? It produces hydrocellulose. Whereas if you treat the viscose rayon in a strong oxidizing agent, what will happen? It produces oxycellulose. Both the cases, hydrocellulose as well as oxycellulose, what will happen? It breaks down of the molecular chain, that is, the degradation takes place. In both the cases, either the formation of hydrocellulose or the formation of oxycellulose leads to degradation of your viscose rayon. In case of acids, the cellulose chain is attacked at the old linkages, whereas the oxidizing agent attacks the two secondary hydroxyl groups present in the cellulose. So this is how the attack of your acid as well as your oxidizing agent. When you treat it with the acid, it attacks the old linkage. When you treat it with the oxidizing agent, it attacks the two secondary hydroxyl group present in the viscose rayon. Hydrocellulose and oxycellulose are weaker than cellulose. Yes. And their formation is destructive process because the degradation it starts taking place whether hydrocellulose or oxycellulose formation. Photocellulose is another type of degradation, that is partial oxidation with respect to the sunlight. When the viscose rayon is exposed to ultraviolet rays, so your partial oxidation may take place. It leads to photocellulose formation. Again, it is one type of degradation process. to the effect of light. Light has a deteriorating influence on all regenerated cellulosic products, and degradation takes place on the surface exposed to sunlight. Yes, when the viscose rayon is exposed to sunlight, it starts the sunlight, it starts degrading your cellulosic component present in the viscose rayon. In due both to water as well as to the UV rays, the damage to viscose rayon slightly greater in an atmosphere of 45% relative humidity than the 65% to 90% relative humidity. So viscose rayon loses its tensile strength when exposed to ultraviolet rays, and loses more when exposed to daylight. This is due to the formation of photocellulose. This already we discussed in the degradation property of your viscose rayon. Now let us discuss the other properties of your viscose rayon. Action of dry heat. Most regenerated cellulose under the influence of heat as well as light shows rapid loss in strength. These changes bring accompanied by an increase in copper number and alkali solubility. So the quality index of viscose fiber decreases either as the temperature increases or as the moisture content of the surrounding atmosphere increases. Both the breaking strength and the fluidity of the viscose rayon appears to be the function of the relative humidity. the samples are exposed. Degradation of cellulose is slower in the absence of O2. Continued heating in the absence of O2 leads to deterioration of the cellulose. So if cellulose is exposed relatively high temperature, there is a drastic degradation of the material occurs. So short heating at high temperature at about 140 degrees Celsius is less harmful than long heating at low temperature. Why we have to study this action of dry heat? Because once the dress material is made of viscose rayon, the dress material may subject to ironing process. So it may help at what temperature we have to iron the viscose rayon fabrics. So this will help during the ironing process. Then coming to the action of acid, the resistance of regenerated cellulosic rayon to acid is generally less than that of cotton, even to the same concentration of the same acid. Organic acids like acetic acid and formic acid can be safely used at a concentration of 1 to 2% in dry condition without damage to the fiber. But if you take inorganic acids such as sulfuric acid and nitric acid or hydrochloric acid, it will surprisingly the strong concentration provided the temperature. It will degrade your viscose rayon. So in all cases, acid must be neutralized thoroughly and must certainly not be allowed to dry on the material or serious weakness will result. So your organic acid does not damage your fiber, whereas inorganic acid it will damage your viscous rayon. In continuation of action of acid, oxalic acid removal of oil iron stains is not recommended except at temperature lower than 65 degrees Celsius. At higher temperature and concentration, all acids will destroy or carbonize the regenerated rayons. Acid in contact with yarn causes rayon to become hard and brittle. Acid tends to swelling of viscous rayon filament. So these are all the action of acids with respect to your viscous rayon. Now let us see the action of oxidizing agents. Oxidizing agents are used for bleaching of viscous rayon. As regenerated fibers are made from bleached pulp and are bleached by the producers, it is not necessary to use bleaching agents to restore their whiteness. So there is no necessity for the action of bleaching, because already the fibers are bleached, okay, during the production itself. But peroxide solution can weaken at 65 degrees Celsius. Hence, Hydrogen peroxide is applied below 55 degrees Celsius. NA2O2 is not suitable for this purpose. Whereas your sodium hypochlorite in acidic solution has a destructive bleaching action and can only be applied at cold condition in great dilution. So alkaline sodium hypochlorite solutions are much milder in their action than in acidic condition. So you have to use the sodium hypochlorite solution, whether in an acidic medium or in an alkaline medium. Okay. Then KMnO4, it bleached, should be used only in mild acid solution at an acidic condition, as the formation of MnO2 prevents the bleaching action from proceedings. Then hydrogen sulfate compounds as sodium hydrosulfide, sodium sulfoxylate formaldehyde or basics or normal zinc sulfoxylate formaldehyde, as well as other reducing compounds, form smaller quantities of hydrocellulose in regenerated cellulose yarns. When treatment is too drastic, so these are all the actions of oxidizing agents on your viscous rayon. Then coming to the action of soap. Ordinary soap, that is regenerated cellulosic materials, improves proper use of soap or use of poorly soap results in rancidity and odor in rayon fabrics or yarn. So when soap alone is used, there is a tendency for the ionized fatty acids from the soap to adhere tenaciously to the individual rayon filament. This is prevalent on oil delustered rayon because of the fatty acid radical of the soap adheres tenaciously to the minute oil globules in the structure of the rayon. The fatty acid radical will produce croup on the fabric or fiber after long duration. So rancidity can be prevented by a final during the drying of such materials and subsequent storage. The free rings with hard water. So this property is very much useful whenever the dress material is subjected to washing. Because while washing, the detergent contains soap as well as with alkali. So you have to take care of all these properties while the viscose fabric is subject to washing process. Then coming to the action of solvents. Solvents such as pine oil, hydrogenated hydrocarbons, benzene, toluene, xylene and carbon tetrachloride can be safely used on regenerated rayons. They are employed as a spotting agent before or during scouring process as an addition to the occurring boiling of the bath. So you can use all the type of solvents. Okay, either pine oil or hydrogenated hydrocarbons, benzene, toluene, xylene, carbon tetrachloride can be safely used for the viscose rayon. Then coming to the effect of iron ironing process. Effect of iron. Iron means ironing process. See, FeOH2 tends to weaken the rayon ion directly in the presence of soil moisture, carbonic acid, iron is transferred and is readily absorbed by the rayon. On exposure to air, FeOH2 absorbs O2 and forms FeOH2. So once the formation of FeOH2, what will happen? It will tend to weaken the viscose rayon. At this time, Fe salt is very active and may act as a catalyst under certain conditions and converting cellulose into oxycellulose. Already we might be discussed, once the formation of oxycellulose, it starts the degradation of your viscose rayon. So this results in tendering, staining and touching of rayon to iron or iron surface as its occurs tinting or boiling off or throwing and dyeing must be avoided. All traces of stains can be removed in 5 to 15 minutes. percent concentration of oxalic acid at about 65 degrees Celsius. So all traces of stains can be removed. By treating with oxalic acid at a concentration of 1 to 2% at about 65 degrees Celsius for 5 to 15 minutes within 15 minutes. So by this treatment is not used in case of regenerated as it is a harsh treatment. Then coming to the dyeing properties, viscose fibers can be dyed using the dyes which are used for dyeing of cotton material like direct dyes, reactive dyes, VAT dyes. So you can use the dyes which is used to dye cotton materials. But the dye should be carried out at a lower temperature, not at higher temperature. Presence of retarding agent and low concentration of electrolyte, that is sodium chloride, for a good affinity and better exhaustion. So if you want to get good affinity and better exhaustion, so you have to use lower concentration of electrolytes, that is sodium chloride. It is used as an exhausting agent. Then coming to the physical variation in viscose rayon arising during the manufacturing becomes more apparent after dyeing. So if there is any variation, definitely you will come to know after the dyeing process. So if there is any physical variation in the viscose rayon, when you will come to know after the dyeing process, it will more apparent. You can easily visible the difference. Okay, results in difference dielectric of different filaments. So coming to the next property is biological properties. The moth, mildew, yes, it will attack your viscose rayon and cause discoloration and stains in your viscose rayon. So both moth and mildew will attack your viscose rayon. It will affect the strength. It will affect the diaphinity and luster of your viscose rayon. So dry viscose rayon is rarely attacked by the moth and mildew. The presence of moth and mildew, it depends upon the type of warp size, temperature and the humidity of these storage conditions. So when this moth and mildew will attack, it depends upon the size content and the temperature and the storage conditions. Then coming to the end uses of your viscose rayon. Viscose rayon is suitable for, actually it is used for apparel purpose. It is used as a curtains, furniture coverings, transports, then furniture, tablecloths, cushions, bedspreads, quilt covers, lace, fine fabrics, sportswear, and other dress materials. Even it is used as a tire cord. So these are all the uses of your viscose rayon. It is used even in making amber lock cloths, even sometimes protective cloths, your face mask is made up of viscose rayon. It is used as a sewing embroidery threads. So viscose plus cotton, it is used as this blend is nowadays used for apparel, dress materials. It will reduce the cost of the material. Then viscose plus polyester. This blend is also used for comfort. It gives strength and good absorbency. So viscose plus polyester also can be preferred. Okay, but it is not suitable as a sea ropes or fishing nets or insect netting and other fields related to chemical contacts. Because viscose rayon is, it will easily attacked by chemicals. So that is the reason why it is not used in sea ropes or fishing nets or insect netting purpose. But it is used in some other